Hello and welcome to After Before Friday, week number 29. Today I'm going to be post-processing an image of Pier 7 in San Francisco that is underexposed and filled with noise as a result of my ISO level of 500. I'm going to be using a combination of noise reduction using Nick Dfine2, Lightroom, and Nick Color Efex Pro. So to begin the workflow, I'm want to ready my image for import into Dfine2. And what I've learned that the best approach to converting raw files and processing them for noise reduction involves a few simple yet very important steps. And the first is to set your white balance, because once you bring it into a NIC program and export it out, the white balance that you have chosen is embedded in the image, and so you can no longer adjust it but for the settings that would otherwise be available in a TIFF or a JPEG image. So set your white balance first. Now this is as shot. It was a cloudy day, and so I'm going to choose cloudy, which it's hard to see at this exposure. It's just warming it up a bit. So from there, I'm going to increase the exposure so that I can see the noise that I'm dealing with, and I'm going to leave it about here. And then the last thing, I have an import, a sharpening preset upon Lightroom import, and you don't want to have any sharpening applied to your image before you bring it into Nick Dfine. It will be working across purposes. It makes Dfine less effective. And any sharpening that you do before bringing it in creates, you know, some halos and artifacts, and then the noise reduction software struggles to remove that. So you want to go in with a clean image. So I'm going to remove my preset, my sharpening preset, and Lightroom also has a default color reduction preset of 25, so be sure to remove that as well. So now we have a clean image to bring into Nick Dfine. And to get there, I'm going to right-click on my mouse. It pulls up my menu and edit in Dfine2. Now this is going to take a second as it pulls up this menu for taking it into the program. And these are all basically default values for Nick Dfine2. To explain them, it's going to export as a TIFF. This color space is sRGB, which is what the standard is for web viewing. If you were going to print, and I'm not a printer, but I've been told that Profoto is the color space to choose. 16-bit is what the TIFF image will be converted from a RAW. You want that for the highest quality. The resolution, if you're printing, 240 at a minimum, 300, I think 300 is what you choose if you go into, let's see, Profoto. I think it 300, but for our purposes, 240 is fine, although even for screen resolution, you can do it for 72 dots per inch. And then compression, I have learned to leave that off. For some reason, it can create some problems with a TIFF file format. So this is where I'm going to leave it. I'm going to put it back to sRGB because I'm not going to be printing this image. And then I'm going to click Edit. And it will bring it into the program. And it takes probably 10 to 15 seconds to do that. It's thinking, so bear with me. And as it begins to pull it in, you'll see, I don't know if you saw this, but down here on my film strip, it has created a TIFF image. And it is to this image that any edits that I apply in Nick Dfine will ultimately be pulled into. So let's go into the program. And my program is set to automatically profile the noise in the image. And what it does is it decides, the program decides what areas it wants to sample. And from that sample, it, as you see it's working, it's going to analyze the noise. For this tutorial, I'm going to let the program do its own thing. For later tutorials, I can manually choose which areas I want the program to sample from. You basically want areas that don't have texture, because wanted texture, because otherwise it will be removed by the program automatically. If you have a blue sky, a flat blue sky, normally that's where noise shows up. You would sample from that. For here, as I said, I'm going to let the program do its thing. And you see, as it pulled, you know, it's sampling from the sidewalk, and you can see as I go back between and pull this line, the before and after, on the left is the before, and on the right is the after, and you can see that it smoothed out the sidewalk. And I'm not sure that I would do that had I chose the areas on my own. Again, we'll leave it. One thing I want to show you, if at this point I can export this back out into Lightroom, but if I want to go in and see exactly the kind of noise or how well the program did, I can go into Zoom View, and I'm going to zoom in 100%, and I'm going to come over here to the lamppost. And let's see once it stops working. Okay, so there's the before on the left and the after on the right. Two types of noise, contrast or luminance and chrominance. Luminance, if I click on this mode, it's going to pull up and it's going to convert it to black and white, which makes it easier to see just the luminance noise as opposed to the color noise. And you can see, let's see if I can zoom into 300 here so you can see better. There we go. You can see in the black and white image that it did a really good, you know, a really good job at reducing the luminance noise. If I wanted to tweak that a little bit more, I would come over here on the right and click on reduce, and it brings up these sliders. 100% is the default value for the removal of noise in Dfine. So if I wanted to remove contrast noise more, I could, of course, move the slider to the right and pull out more noise, should I want to. I'm going to leave it at 100% because I think it did a good enough job. I don't want it to become the image to become too soft. Back in the mode panel, I want to pull up now the color noise, and you'll see what you just saw was everything go dark. This is kind of like a masking effect, and the white areas are where the chrominance noise or color noise is. So again, it did a great job, although there's quite a bit of, you know, outlining left that it didn't deal with. Again, if, and we can try, I can slide the color noise slider to the right to see what happens. And it, you know, it pulls some out. You want to be careful that you don't do too much. So, you know, for based on this lamppost, let's see, I'm just going to boost it up to 125. If I go to another area, and I know this is a problem area on the image since I've dealt with it before, the boat has a lot of color noise. And in this program, sorry, this is a little hard at 300%. It makes it hard to pinpoint. I know from experience beforehand that it didn't do a great job with removing the color noise in the boat. I may just bump it up just a little bit more. And I'm going to leave it there for purposes of this tutorial. I come back here and I go back to RGB, which will bring up my picture. You can see there's the color noise that you're seeing. I'm going to leave this any additional color noise edit for Lightroom. Let me go back to the full image. I'm trying to go back to the, there we go. So it's working. And at this point, again, it may be hard for you to see, and it's hard for me to see at the full picture level, but if you look down here on the right, as I go through the loop, you'll be able to see it. Left is before and right is after. Still a little bit hard to see. Anyway, that gives you some idea of how Dfine2 works. I'm going to click Save, and this is going to now process the image, and it's going to pull the edits that I've just made back into this TIFF file that's on my film strip. And you'll see, once this is done, it will close, the program will close, and Lightroom will open and we'll wait for it to show up on the film strip. So bear with me for a minute. There we go. This is going to load. And there is the after image. It's softer than the before. That's because the noise is removed. And there's the after. Now at this point, I want to go in and apply my basic Lightroom edits. So I'm going to come up to the basics panel. And oops, where's my basics? There we go. And before I forget, I want to crop this image. So let me do that first. It's a little bit on an angle. And I'm going to just correct that. Okay. Again, I know from before that I want 60. So let me just edit that in there and hit enter. So there we go. Now I've got my edit. And the first thing I'm going to do, I've got the exposure is where I want it. So I'm going to head down. I'm going to open up the shadows just a bit. I love this slider. It just recovers detail in darker areas. So for instance, on his backpack, we'll pull that up just a bit. Highlights, I'm going to pull them up just a bit just to brighten the picture a little bit. And I'm going to leave that there. Blacks, I want to bring down to a black point. So I'm going to slide it to the right just to the clipping point. You'll see the clipping. And there, I've just clipped it in the backpack. And then I'm going to apply a bit of clarity, which is a micro contrast. It boosts the midtones. So upwards, I'm going to give it to about there. You can play with that and see what looks best for you. Tone curve, I can come in. I want to see what it looks like with medium contrast. Darkens it a bit too much for me. I'm going to keep that off and go back to the basics. The last thing I'm going to do is apply a graduated filter for the sky, because I want to bring back in some of that detail. And as I pull down, if I hold shift, it will pull down straight. It'll make it easier. So I'm going to pull down on the graduated filter, and I'm going to decrease the exposure. Always make sure that you zero out the effects of any of the selective adjustment tools by double-clicking on effect, and it will zero out all the sliders. And then I'm going to pull down the exposure. Let's see what that looked like before. Okay, now I'm going to accept that. And at this point, the next step in my process is going to be taking it into Nik Color Effects Pro. So I'm going to use the same procedure as I did for Dfine, Nik Dfine. I'm going to pull up the menu, edit it in Color Effects Pro. Once again, it pulls up the menu, the settings. I'm going to leave this where it is, edit, and it's going to pull it into the program, hopefully more quickly than before. Now see, down here, it just created the empty TIFF file where those edits are going to show up. Once I'm done, pulls this up, and it pulls the image in. Now I have a number of the presets that I really love to use in this program, and those are the ones that I'm going to use here. So just give it a second. And sometimes it preloads. This must be the last one I used. I'm going to zero out and empty all the filters so that I can start from scratch. This is the split preview. This is a preview I work from. The full screen will show you, you know, changes in the full screen, it's hard to compare. The side-by-side, if you had a very large monitor, I think it would work. The images aren't large enough for me to see the changes this way. So I typically stay in split view, and you can move as a Dfine and any of the NIC programs, you move this line back and forth, and you can see that the before is on the left and the after is on the right. Okay, so the first filter that I'm going to apply is Pro Contrast. And if I come down here on the left and I click on the stack, it will open up and show me the choices that I have within that filter. One of my favorites is the Dynamic Contrast. So I'm going to apply the preset. And for purposes of this video, I can tweak some of these settings, and I might have if I had more time, but I don't want to make this so long. I'm going to leave this one at its default values. But notice you can play around with the sliders to suit your picture and what you're going for. Again, this is the after, there's the before and the after. And I love the contrast that it brings in. So I'm going to leave that one and I'm going to add another filter. Remember, to add a filter, make sure you click Add Filter. If you just go over into the menu and you pull in a filter without clicking Add, it will remove the existing filter and replace it with the one you choose. So you have to start over again or re-add the filter it removed. So click Add Filter. The next one that I like to use is Darken, Lighten, Center. Again, click on the stack, and I typically go for maximum depth. And you'll see now, with both filters applied, there's the before and there's the after. As a note, you can go in and you can uncheck any of the filters to remove the effect that you have given it, so that you can see what the single filter does when it's applied. But since I want to use these in concert, I'm going to click back on Pro Contrast. Now, I normally, with this filter, do tweak the values. You'll see these are the default luminosity, border luminosity, center size, and shape. There are two shapes, one and two. For me, this is too bright in the middle to begin with, and it's too dark on the borders. This is basically, I use this as a vignetting tool, which is much more effective than Lightroom vignetting tool, which I love to use, but you can place the center of the brightness anywhere in the photo, unlike in Lightroom. I will show you, it says place center, right? I think the default must be smack dab in the middle, but if I for some reason wanted to place it over here on the right and I click, you'll see, I can place it wherever I want. So let's go back here and I'm going to click here and place it there just for now, and I'm going to decrease the center luminosity because, again, I just think it's a bit too bright, and I'm going to pull it down. Now, let's see, I'm just going to pull it down there for now, and the border luminosity I'm going to bring up because, again, that's just a little too dark. I just want some interest here going down the pier. The center size is fine. And let me play around again with the center and make sure I've got it where I want it to be. Sometimes I just play here. I think that's where it was to begin with. So bear with me as I play. I want the foreground a little bit brighter, so I may change this to 2. You can see if I go back and forth what the difference in size. And I may do that. I'm going to leave it at 2. And once more, play around with the center. Okay. I think that's good. So the before, or there's the before, and there's the after. And if I switch off the dark and light and center, you'll see the difference. And again, it's a vignetting, and it helps draw the eye. The last filter I want to add, while I did a graduated filter in Lightroom, I want to see what the effect will be of adding that to the sky here, the graduated neutral density filter. I'm going to start with dark skies and see what that does. I'm going to click this off again. I like a little bit more detail in the sky, so I think I'm going to use that. I can show you with the strong dark skies, and I think that's just over-processed. You know, it's a decision. But these are also sliders that I can play with. The upper tonality, this is how dark the upper portion is. And you can see I can slide it, maybe darken it just a little bit. The lower tonality is at zero. If I wanted to brighten it a little bit more, I could, which I just may. Blending, it does something, and I haven't quite figured it out. But I'm going to leave it at the default for right now. And then vertical shift is how far down from the top the upper tonality comes. So if I bring it to the right, you'll see that it darkens the whole picture. I don't want the whole picture darkened. I'm just looking for the sky. So I'm going to leave it probably about here. I don't remember what the default was, but I'm just looking here at the picture. And I like that. You can also rotate the filter 180. You may see as I, and it depends on your picture, what you want to do, but you can see it as it goes around. So there's a lot of power here in this. Let's get it back to default. Close enough. There's a lot of power in the graduated neutral density filter in Color Efex Pro. Now, if I wanted to save these settings, in case I decide once I get back in Lightroom I'm not quite happy with it, I can hit Save Recipe. If I choose not to do that, once I leave this program, these changes are lost. So I won't have any record of what I had done. So I oftentimes will hit Save Recipe, and it pulls up this box, and I can enter whatever name I want, and then hit OK. I'm not going to save this. Well, maybe I will just, let's see, Pier 7.3, and hit OK. And it will show up with a number of other recipes that I have put together. OK, so now I hit save, and it's going to bring it back into Lightroom one more time. Let me open Lightroom, and we'll, it's going to bring it back into this TIFF file that it created when it opened Color Efex Pro. Let's see where it is. Oh, it's still working. And the last, I will do a couple of last things in Lightroom before closing out the image. And one I can see right off the bat is spot removal. And the last is a post-crop vignette, a slight post-crop vignette. Okay, so there's the image we've got, and I want to zoom in because you can see that the graduated neutral density filter has given me some spots I need to deal with. So I'm going to deal with those, and see, there's one over here, deal with that. And there's a small one here, deal with that. Okay, I come back out to fit. And there may be a few more, but that's good for our purposes, and hit done. I'm also going to, let me pull in here to the street lamp. And you'll see from the street lamp, there's the chromatic aberration or the color and the color noise that wasn't taken care of in Dfine2. So I'm going to deal with it here in Lightroom, and you go under Lens Correction, and you click Remove Chromatic Aberration, and hit Auto. And you see, it's done a wonderful job. Let me go back. This was before, and this was after. Voila! Look at that. I'm going to go back to Fit, and now I'm going to apply a post-crop vignette. And let's see, I think I'll do my number one setting, and there's the final image. So let's see if I can find the before. Let's see. There's the before. And there's the after. Very long-winded video. I hope that you have stuck with me. There is a lot here. And in coming weeks, I will go into more depth about Dfine2. But until that time, I hope you've enjoyed watching this. If you're watching this on YouTube, you can see more post-processing galleries of after before pictures and videos on my blog, visualventuring.com. Visit there and click on After Before Friday Forum to see all the choices. Thanks for watching, everyone.